While we continue to chat and chew, I would beg your indulgence just for a few seconds, and then we'll continue with the festivities. I thought it was important today to convene this gathering in order to celebrate the success of Franklin. In her success, I think we can particularly those of us who are a bit older, can appreciate this young lady for all that she has done, but more importantly, for all that she is. She represents the best that we collectively as a community have to offer. I'm proud of her. Obviously, I'm a little biased. That's okay too. But you know, we know in Atlantic City that all too often media and other sources seem to accentuate the negative. And we don't celebrate the positive as a community, as a family, enough. And it reminds me of a biblical reference where a question was asked, is there anything good that can come out of Nazareth? And oftentimes I contemplate that same question. You know, people say, is there anything good that can come out of Atlantic City? There is a living testament. There are a lot of students, my son included, who make us all proud as a community. Frankie's not unique. She's not the only one. But she's one of the best of the best. And so I thought that it would be altogether fitting and proper for us to get together to collectively just tell Frankie that we're proud of her and to wish her the best as she leaves one chapter of her life, that being high school, in pursuit of the next chapter. Frankie, I'm proud of you. As a community, I'm sure we all are. Thank you to the Boys and Girls Club. Your parents should be, and grandparents, should be extremely proud of the job that they have done raising you in this community. And again, it just proves it can be done. I'd like to say there's nothing really special about my wife and I. There's nothing really special about Frankie's parents. But if we as parents make a commitment to shepherd ours in the right direction and hold fast to the values that we instill in them, they're going to be all right. And so, again, all of us can celebrate your accomplishments, and we're here today just to say thank you for making us proud.
Congratulations to as a First Lady, I just want to say I salute you. And as a future mother-in-law, I want to say I admire you. Continue on. You have done well. I'm very proud of you. I really am. I remember when Elijah came home and started talking about somebody named Frankie. I was confused. I was so confused. But then when he told me who you were and that you had a sister named Frankie and a brother named Frank, I said, well, you know what? It must be good. So he said, but Mom, she's the smartest girl that I have ever met. He said, she is the smartest girl. And I said, and you know what? I said, well, based on that, she can help you with some of that homework that you're going to be facing, AP and honors classes. So I'm glad she's smart. But all jokes aside, I'm very proud of you. And especially as a board member for the Atlantic City Board of Education, this gives me a platform to say that our kids do well. And I'm telling you, I will be leading that charge and using your name every chance I get. Elijah, I'm proud of you too. You have done well. You have done well. And Mr. E, can you come up for one moment, please? I just met Mr. E and we had a wonderful conversation. And I just want you to share with me, you know, just some of the little stuff you said about Frankie and this whole award. I mean, winning Youth of the Year for the state of New Jersey is huge.
It is
huge. And so when we thought about doing stuff, I said, we have to honor this young lady. And I want to thank you. Just having people like you in the community along to help Nikita with her is so, so very important. And anything that I can do as a board member and as a parent, or as being married to the mayor. You have that from me. You have that commitment from me. Because if this is what, you know, is the product of what can become, I'm on board. I'm on your team too.
Frankie really did step up. There's no question about it. She makes it easy because there's a lot to work with us. It's been said. But it really is a huge accomplishment when you stop to think that that's one out of 80 to 100,000 kids. And it's here in Atlantic City. And it was interesting, after they announced Frankie's name, I shared with you earlier that they said, I don't know what they're putting in the drinking water in Atlantic City, but this makes three out of the last 4 years of the youth of the year has come from Atlantic City. And we're very, very proud of that. It makes it a difficult place to be because now there's an expectation. But we hope to deliver. And I think the, you know, all of what Frankie has, I was sharing earlier, here's a young lady that gets up in the morning, goes and takes honors AP classes, most demanding classes at the high school. She rows crew, and that's a demanding sport. In terms of time, she does everything. The difficult thing is how to balance that time. That's the only time that we've had to come and say, let's work that out. How do you do two things at one time? But all the Champions of Youth things that she, you know, has been involved with, and then went this quarter to take three classes at Atlantic Cape Community College classes at nighttime. So, and then get up and do it all over again. So we're very, very proud of Frankie. And, I would finish by simply saying that there's still a lot to smile about, but a lot of work to do. Frankie goes in July, starts this whole thing all over again at the regional level in New York City. She's got 3 days. And if she should come back with that, it's another $22,000 in her scholarship and a trip to the White House. I'm hoping to get with her. The story was that, you know, Denzel Washington happens to be a sports person for the Boys and Girls Club.
I'm gone. I'm her chaperone.
I said, the heck with that. Jennifer Lopez is still the spokesperson too. So, so we'll have to flip for that.
Denzel is our
name. Well, thank you.
Frankie, if you would, this is just a small token of our appreciation here in the city of Atlantic City. And I don't know, should I let the chat out to know about council? Council will be honoring you as well.
Okay.
But this is from the mayor's office. It's just a certificate of recognition, which is well-deserved.
I have some treats for you.
Oh,
I think you'll like these awards better.
My dorm room. It's an honor to be recognized by the mayor's office in the city of Atlantic City. Oh, he says such wonderful things about me. I can't believe it. But it doesn't seem, when I'm doing this stuff, it doesn't seem like it's that much work. So my mom's like, Frankie, you quit. I'm like, wow, okay. But just thank you all. My mom, family, everyone. You gotta say, I've got to throw my castle away over dreams. I am fit out of perfect come true. Though you never knew it was of you, I've been dreaming. The Sandman has come from too far away for you to say come back some other day. And though you don't believe that they do, when I looked at you, and maybe two if you would believe, you too might be overjoyed.
just to find. I had found what I've searched to discover. I've come much too far for me now to find. The love that I sought can never be mine. And though you don't believe that they do, they do come true. For did my dreams come true when I looked at you? And maybe too, if you